into the position, right? Ladies and gentlemen, agents of fortune.
Thank you. Yeah.
headdress. Nothing.
Consciousness. Snake.
Yeah. Yeah. watching. And it's our time to special guest Albert Bouchard. We're going to be right back with an extended regular set. Stick around about 10 minutes. We'll be right back.
Okay.
slightly to play now the golden age of leather. So if you know this song, sing along with us. It starts off, Buck is going to lead us in the beginning vocal part. So if you like to sing along with us. Yeah, it's all about beer, women, motorcycles, and partying. So this is sort of a pub, I guess. So it's a bar, right? So raise your can of beer on high. You know how it goes. Yeah, all right. So pick your note, everybody. Raise. Our bunch going to lead us. Here we go.
Raise your can of beer on high and seal your faith forever. Our best years have passed us by. The golden age of
the fire to the night. I'm burning. We'll be right back.
composition, something we just started playing recently. Oh, we're going to play something now about extraterrestrials, hard to believe. This is Richie and Buck on the guitars. It's called The Vigil.
Days are numbered, and I look away to the heavens. Thank you.
We're getting to go back to the first album now. All right, Gary Perry, then came The Last Days of May. I guess most of you know the true story of Then Came the Last Days of May. But I wrote this song a long time ago. It's about some guys who tried to cop some illegal substances back in the 60s. They went in a car in New York and drove to the southwestern part of the United States in order to cop these goods, which is now illegal in most of the USA. And met a fate they didn't truly deserve. So here it is, Then Came the Last Days of May.
Three good bottles of lemonade smoking in the back of
Yeah, Richie and Buck on the guitars there. Let's not forget Kazim Sultan on the bass. And James Ripino on the drums. Hello, Kerry Gabriel. Let's hear some gigantic footsteps heading to Ireland. They're not up to that yet. We have to do it, order. Ladies and gentlemen, on the vocal and the guitar, Richie Castellano and Hot Rails to Hell!
We'll be right back.
I hear gigantic footsteps coming this way now. It's coming out of the rhythm. Could it have swum all the way here? Is it possible? Uh-oh, there goes the Barney Stone. We'll be right back. What a great night. Thanks for coming. Thank you. We had something planned. and we're going to do what we had planned, but there's about 15 extra minutes, so I want to play as much as we can. So, we're going to throw our guys in the booth a little curveball, and, you know, fuck it, let's keep playing a little extra stuff. For the next two songs, and then we're gonna do what we plan to do. If we play a little late, then it will sue us, right? All right, we gotta play a song that's a. Before we start, we have to dedicate the whole evening, actually, this whole next 2 weeks. We've had a crew guy on our stage for many, many years, Sam Judd. I guess a lot of you people recognize the website Hot Rails to Hull, which is our history website, fan-based, and Sam passed away. So, we're going to dedicate the show to Sam, and to our founding mentor and creator, Sandy Cronin. And also, always, Dr. Allen.
Thank you.
story of Elric. Elric was an albino boy, the son of the king. Except being albino, he was very poor of sight, very thin of arms and legs. He was very weak. He was a failure to his father. His father didn't think he could take up the crown of the king. He became a bookish boy, unable to lift even any kind of weapon. But he did hear of a quest he could take. A quest he could take to find a magical broadsword hidden up in the hills, far away from the kingdom, in the Dreaming Isle. So as a teenage boy, he took off on the quest to find the magical Cave of Flesh. And he entered the Cave of Flesh, and his cousin followed him because he also wanted the broadsword. He was jealous, and he went into the Cave of Flesh, and there, suspended in the air, was the broadsword Stormbringer, and it jumped into his hand as if it was his own, and he felt the strength of 100 men, and then began the story of the Black Lady.
I just wanna be a lover, and I went out scared. I wish We'll be right back.
Dublin. Thank you. Maybe we'll see some new album tomorrow. Good night. It's about fucking time.